What's up, guys? It's been a long ass time since I've been able to kind of talk and vlog and just kind of give you guys an update. It's been a long ass time. So it is September 1st, first day of the ninth month of the year, and this year is fully flown by. Right now I'm getting ready to head over to a shoot over at GBT, heading over to a shoot for GBT. So we are getting ready for the biggest drop ever. This drop is going to be like something that's going to kind of like change a lot of things. We've been taking this whole week to get as much content as possible. So this is going to be shoot number probably like 7 or 10 on the Thursday. Let me go ahead and grab everything. So for those of you guys that are not familiar, I have been prepping for a bodybuilding show. I'm about like maybe 3 weeks into prep so far. I'm down, I want to believe, 7 pounds at this point. So we'll be talking a lot about that, but I just wanted to kind of upload a vlog and kind of keep you guys updated as to what's been going on into like my personal life, my fitness life, all that kind of stuff. And I feel like I haven't been able to do so. But as of late, I've been eating a lot, probably the most I've been eating in a very, very long time. So what we have here is going to be my pre-workout meal. So that's going to be 40 grams of whey protein over here. That's already shaken up inside of a Go One More BPM shaker cup. We have, I believe, 2 rice cakes. And then I need to grab my pre-workout shake, which is going to be creatine and 20 ounces of water. So this is what I'm going to be drinking 30 minutes prior to my workout. And then this food is going to be what I'm going to be eating an hour and 30 minutes out of my workout. So today we have 2 shoots to knock out. We got shoot number one that's involved me, Taylor. This is a girl that we've been using for some of our shoots lately. And then after that, we have a shoot with Weez and Barbara. Barbara is a model that's kind of new to Houston. And yeah, we got a long day ahead of us. So let's go ahead and get going. Also, my car's in the shop, so. Go, my man. Yes, sir.
Rusev?
Yes, sir.
What up? What up?
What up? Damn. Oh, what's up, bro?
What's up? How's it going?
What's up, bro?
Yeah, just straight up.
What's up, man? Oh, this is dope, man. This is like perfect. Okay, like, perfect morning vibes and everything like that.
This place is cool.
I'm vlogging today because
hey, guys. What's up, guys?
I need a video of this. Is Aaron, by the way.
What up?
Future, like he's a back ambassador, shooter,
all that,
all encompassing. Yeah, this is perfect. This is like early 2000s. That's like 80s, 90s, like a mixture of 80s, 90s, 70s, all that kind of stuff.
And it's black on.
Yeah, it's black. Say it again.
And it's black on.
This is dope, man. Holy shit. All right, so, I mean, we're here on time. One of the things that you run into in drops in general, right? Nothing really ever goes as planned, if that makes sense. Our model, Taylor, is not gonna get here until like another 30 minutes, probably. Yeah, no, I'm not blasting. I'm just saying, like, I'm trying to provide an example. I'm trying to provide an example as to like, things always go the way that you plan. And that's probably fine. We might just get some like side content, try to figure out, just cause like the studio itself is super dope, right? Like, look at this, man. It's a really nice setup. So like what we're gonna do for today's skit is, you know, like in those 90 videos, right? When like they have like a celebrity guest appearance, that's kind of the concept of the shoot. Like what's gonna happen is that Taylor's gonna be walking up to my table. I'm like reading a menu and she's like, can I get something for you? And then, are you ready to order? And then it's me. I look up and like, you know, the audience, quote unquote, it's like, woo, like clapping, all that type of stuff. And then I say, I'm gonna get this back. So that's kind of like the basis of what this video is gonna do. I'm thinking too, we can just get some little shots here and there, just cause it's like literally just set up like kind of like a restaurant or something like that. So we'll try to figure out what we're gonna do. Right now we got Ann getting BTS like shots and all that kind of stuff. So we got it. We got her for like another 50 or so minutes. So let's see how that goes. All right, so we're getting the scene set up right now. So what we're gonna be doing is getting like the basic scene set up. So you can get that wide shot, kind of get an idea where everyone's gonna be. Taylor's gonna come in from this angle over here whenever she arrives. And then we're gonna give like Weez and Bella like a little bit of a talking, just to add a little bit more character and volume to the scene. And then that's when she's gonna walk over to me and then just ask me like, oh, is there anything I wanna order? I'm gonna turn to the camera and then it's gonna be one of those, yeah, clapping, clapping, clapping. And then I can sit there and say something. So. That's the general setup right now. Who's gonna deliver the line? Like, there's no macros or nothing here fits my macros.
I don't know. You got that.
You got it?
Yeah, she's got it.
All right, let's see. Nothing here fits my macros. So we just wrapped up the shoot. Pretty simple. Pretty straightforward. So right now we're about to head over to the camera store to pick up.
We're gonna pick up lighting and pick up a body for.
Okay, so then we're gonna go do that. We have a secondary shoot that's gonna be like an old school type of like 90s, like gymnasium PE type of deal. We have that shoot at 4 p.m. So we're gonna bring up the lighting, probably go back to HQ, relax a little bit, and then we're gonna go to that shoot. That shoot, John, has to be pretty fast as well. So Wheez is going to go pick up some of the props to make that happen. And then after that, we're gonna train. And then I'll kind of update you guys with like all the powerlifting stuff or the bodybuilding stuff and, you know, training, nutrition, dieting, cardio, all that. But first, we gotta focus on GBT and get that done. So we're almost at the end of content week. I told the team we gotta lock in for this week and sacrifice and work super hard so we can have next week be pretty seamless and just like focus on promoting the fuck out of this new drop coming. I know a lot of you guys were asking about these shorts coming out on TikTok and Instagram. Well, next Saturday, it's gonna be the day. All right, guys, we're back at HQ. So we have about T-minus 2 hours until the next shoot. So the next shoot is gonna be like around the corner over at this community center. Like I mentioned earlier, it's gonna be like this old school physical education PE type of shoot. So that shoot is gonna be really fast. It's literally just Wheez and Barbara that's gonna be the models. It's gonna take probably like, what, 45 minutes?
Yeah, about like an hour.
Like about that, like maybe an hour. And then after that, we're gonna head on to the gym. Check this out, like the HQ over here has been absolutely ridiculous the last couple of weeks because we've been getting a shit ton of product and it's like you can't even like we couldn't properly shelve everything just because this is literally like probably like 3x what we normally do, if not 4x. So it's just like we have so much inventory. I literally had to order things before this drop because things kind of changed the last drop, and all these boxes are literally just product, shorts, tanks, shirts, hat, literally everything, right? So it's just like the packaging or like the shelving is gonna come in whenever this drop kind of goes live. So we kind of miss out on that, but the shelving is gonna help for future drops to help kind of accommodate this amount of volume that we're gonna be moving going forward. So there's just so much stuff coming in, man. It's ridiculous, but also thankful. So we're just kind of rolling with it. It kind of just like grew like exponentially in like one drop. So it's like now we're trying to kind of catch up. And while we're trying to catch up, we're also still trying to drop as well. So it's like, you know, we'll find that balance hopefully with the next drop. But yeah, man, it's been a crazy last couple of weeks. So we're gonna chill here, relax a little bit longer, focus on the shoot, probably get like a little shot list as to like what we want. Wheez is over grabbing the little props and all that. And that's pretty much it, y'all. It's been a busy ass day. Busy day. We just got back from academy, picked up some knickknacks.
Yeah, some knickknacks for the next shoot. So but got some training cones, got some white towels, some sweatbands, and then you got a tennis racket as well with some tennis balls right here. Just for flat lays and whatnot.
Yeah.
Kind of like how we did it with the football shoot with like the cones and the footballs on the turf. So something light, but it's like setting the tone with.
And then the chew, the bubble gum.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's a big thing. I saw this on the way in checkout, and I'm like, let me just grab this real quick.
Let me see it. Is it?
It's purple as well, so it's gonna go with purple
chew. Yeah, big league chew. This is, like I was hoping it's not dip or anything like that.
No, that'd be insane.
More stuff happening. So like as I was, I'll show you guys. Well, I was like watching a bunch of this looks nuts, but I was watching a bunch of bodybuilding stuff. So like I was trying to kind of pick up little things here and there for posing. Just now, these are kind of things that happen behind the scenes that you guys don't really see that often. But just now, Brad, which is our marketing guy, he put together like a quick presentation to something to implement to the website upon checkout, kind of get a better understanding of our customers, and then figure out like number one, what ads work.
Yo, so we are working on.
So like we've been getting a lot of feedback from Brad because he's the one that does like all the analytics for our marketing. So that's why we were doing stuff like that earlier on the shoot, early on in the day with the shoot, right? Trying to get that organic content because that's what does well for our brand. And then on top of that, he's going to implement a survey that's going to help us kind of get more information as to like where do they hear about us, why are they shopping with us, what products do they like, and that'll help us with more ads and then also just product creation as well, product development. So it is 3:16 now, almost time, if not it is time for me to eat my pre-workout meal. So my pre-workout meal is going to be, like it is every day, 2 rice cakes, and then we have 40 grams of whey protein. Obviously VPN, you use my code in shock. But I got the milk and cookies. Flavor here with some chocolate rice cakes. So 2 of these, it's like 90 minutes before I train. So the shoot's gonna take no time at all. So I'm gonna eat this, and then I have my pre-workout shake, which is 30 minutes before my workout. All it is just creatine, 20 ounces of water, and some salt. So we're gonna sip on that. Go ahead and eat now, because I'm not even gonna lie to you, I'm hungry as hell. But I'm excited because I feel like the shoot's gonna be nice as fuck. And then on top of that, I'm ready to deal with some stupid ass shit today. Like, I feel like the last couple of workouts, actually this whole week has just been kind of like getting by. And just like with all the shooting. But today we got a little bit of time to focus in on and list some stupid ass shit today. So I'm looking at a nice pool session, whether it's a lot of weight or not. I just want to come in with a certain level of like nastiness, some type of oomph. Is that right, Aaron? Some type of oomph. Some type of nastiness to it.
We're going
to
bring it today, dude.
Yeah, we bringing it today. I'm going to talk my shit today. I'm going to be on my shit today.
I remember that.
And you know you're editing this video, right?
Yeah, you told me.
Oh, okay, cool. Do you need help?
Yeah.
What's this? That's another thing. So we're here at shoot number two of the day. So we're here at this like recreational type of like center. It looks like an old school like PE class type of vibe here. So we got the model, we got Weeze here. We got Barbara here. She shot with the skit. She shot with us like 2 days ago.
Yeah.
And like, I feel like your performance is gonna win you like a award or something like that.
I think so.
Yeah. But okay, so this shoot is gonna be pretty straightforward. It's gonna be like single, then doubles. So what that means is that we're gonna get shots with just Weeze, then Barbara. Sorry, didn't mean to put that up. And then both of them together. Then after that, we're just gonna get them kind of like a natural environment. So like we have like little bleachers here. So we'll have Barbara kind of like chilling. We'll have like them also suited up with the props that you guys saw earlier. And just give like that natural kind of like PE type of vibe to it. So it's gonna be really fun. Also gonna be really fast. And I'm just happy because I dropped my camera earlier and it broke. So now it's back up. Shout out to Ant, the GOAT. Gave me a free lens to use after I destroyed mine. So let's kick back. Watch these people make magic and get to work. All right, shoot finished. Barbara and Weeze killed it. The shots that we got, yeah, I should have had my phone on. Here we go. The shots that we got were like on point. The vision was clear. It was executed, as you guys can clearly see. So now it's time to train. While we were shooting, Dion and Gio were kind of getting the clothes together for the models that are gonna be shooting for tomorrow. Because there's a lot of models tomorrow and we don't wanna be like kind of just sitting around and not being efficient. So tomorrow should be pretty fast. Not fast, but should be pretty organized in comparison to the shoots that we had prior. But whole team executed for today. Two shoots, now it's time to, damn, that shit close. Now it's time to train, get busy, do some heavy ass shit. So I'll see you guys at the gym. Yeah, it's time to fucking work now. So we up here in Corruption. I already took two scoops of the brie. We about to go stupid, about to go dummy. Got the grill in, got the shoes on, got the shorts on, got the beater on. All right, so we got a single today at 7. Then after that, we have a 3x6 or a 3x5, one of the two. But regardless, we're gonna get this work in. Let's go. Pretty girls, my reputation. One on my arm, that's decoration. Get into it, no hesitation. You dying, dead.
I'm a 8 then. You decide to walk through the crazy then. I'ma buy a house with the lake then. You wanna say that hoe? Put on the tape then. Man, what?
Yeah. All right, so we got 725 pounds on the bar right now. I'm finna smash this shit. I already hit 675, move easy. So I just gotta lock in, be about that shit and hit this shit. So let's go ahead and get to work. Feels good. Yes, sir. And I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I actually switched to an Enzer belt because my SPD belt keeps staining me. So I know a lot of you guys can't really relate to this, but I sweat a lot inside of the gym, especially here at Curb Strength. There's no AC, so it's constant sweat, right? So the inside of the belt is, I forgot, it's a leather, velvet, not velvet, what's suede, there we go. And it bleeds into my belt, or it bleeds into my shirts. So I moved over to Enzer because Enzer doesn't have that, suede inside, Jesus. That suede inside, so it doesn't like bleed into my stuff. So move over to the 10 millimeter Enzer. So now let's bust down to 725 for the top single of today's workout. Standing at my hustle, stimulating my mind, motivating my niggas, and we never divide. No, these niggas won't hold me back. 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 So we got 625 or 725 for the top set. Now I'm feeling like 675 for a nice little set of five. Let's get to work.
Fly through with the death. It's only one God and it's only one crown, so it's only pen overlord. Coast Guard, come a hundred going overboard. I got money with the best of them. Go blow for blow it in Mexico. Don't let your side bitches settle in. Might have to head, but you ever win. Bones, I put numbers on the boards. Hard to get a handle on this double-edged sword. Whether rapping or I'm rapping to a word, might reach back and reel out the rapping of the war. Givenchy fitting like his gym clothes. We really gym stars. I'm like D-Rose.
All right, so we finished up the workout. My camera keeps dying, so I have to keep putting on the charger. But right now we're doing a back workout. I've been practicing my posing a little bit here and there. So like earlier I was watching the Rough Diesel classic posing along with Sebo as well. I have to like recommit to the posing process because I was kind of posing the wrong way before. So it's like little things that I'm doing. So as I'm going through my workout, I stop and I look in the mirror, do a couple poses, get the feeling right inside of my head. So whenever I'm on stage, I don't need a mirror. I just go off to like where I'm feeling my spots at. So I'm really focusing on my front double by, because it's a little bit different from your open bodybuilding. It's more of like you lean on one hip to kind of bring that classic nice little flow to it. So I'm learning how to do that. But a lot of guys have been asking me, like, you know, has my training changed any since doing bodybuilding? The answer is no. I've been training exactly the same. I keep my same routine. I still do my heavy powerlifting stuff, and I transition over to my bodybuilding stuff. And my coach really wants me to kind of just hone in on the fact of, like, my training has got me the physique that I've already gotten. All we have to do is just diet down. So he doesn't want me to train my training just to bodybuilding or anything like that. So we're maintaining what we already do and then just chipping away when it comes to losing weight. So let me get this little back workout out of the way. Okay guys, just finished up doing 50 minutes of cardio. I normally don't like being here this late, but like I said, it's a busy week. So like all my training sessions have been later in the day, where I basically have no choice. So I finished up, it's 9:09 right now. Typically I like to finish my meals for the day. And it's funny because I've only had breakfast and my pre-workout meal and my pre-workout shake. Now this isn't ideal, but my calories are low anyways because it's low days. So I have to fit in three meals when I get back to the crib. So like what I'm gonna do is just cook three meals straight in a row and just eat them. So I'll tell you guys when I get back to the crib. But basically like the first meal I'm gonna eat is gonna be ground beef. It's 96-4 ground beef, and then 65 grams of jasmine rice, and then 100 grams of veggies. Knock that down, and then we have another meal where it's the same meal, just replace the ground beef with chicken, and then another meal where it's just chicken, veggies, and avocado. So I'm gonna knock that out and then go to bed for the day. But it's been like a long ass day, and tomorrow's gonna be even longer. Well, not even longer, but it's just gonna be long as well. So 50 minutes knocked down, not too bad. Deadlift session, 725 top single, and then 675 for five reps, all on a bodybuilding cut. So that's pretty good, but all done. Let's head back to the crib. All right guys, so I pretty much sped home and sped cook these meals. So this is actually three meals split into two. So this includes my, I need to put rice in here, but there's supposed to be 65 grams of jasmine rice in here, 200 grams of veggies, because this is two meals put together, and then 14 ounces of chicken with 30 grams of avocado. And then in this plate, we have 65 grams of carbs worth of, or 65 grams of jasmine rice with 7 ounces of the lean ground beef, and then 100 grams of veggies. So I literally have to put two meals together in one, just need to add the rice. And then we have another meal over here. So I'm literally just gonna eat all of this at once and try to go to bed, because it's already 10:13. And I typically like to have all my meals done by about like 9:30, 10. So we're just a little bit behind, but was able to make up for some time. So I'm gonna go ahead and eat this, go back to bed, or go to bed. Right now I'm trying to create the playlist for tomorrow's shoot, or actually Josh created it. So I'm trying to choose the song that I wanna use for the like intro teaser, all that kind of stuff. I'm trying to decide between feels so good, and then this is how we do it. So we'll see. But I'm gonna wolf this down, and then see you guys tomorrow. Morning, guys. This probably looks absolutely insane because I have a whole tripod here in my bathroom. But I just did my morning check-ins. It's a little bit early because I have a long day. So it's 7 in the morning right now. I've been up since 4. But typically on Tuesdays and Fridays, I do my check-ins. So I do my check-ins. So what I do is I get my tripod over here, and then I basically show you guys from this little angle right here. I'm trying to put her on my camera so maybe you can see. Well, what I typically do is I'm over here, get my front double wide, right? Go like this. And then I show the back as well. And that pretty much sums up my morning check-in. So then after that, I do a screenshot to kind of show the physique. Then I weigh myself, and then my coach makes adjustments from there. So I'm gonna make breakfast and then weigh myself a little bit after. But I'm gonna get ready to head on to get a haircut, because I get a haircut every single week. So the thing about having a haircut like this, right, is that whenever you have a low, you're getting like constant fades on the side, it kind of grows back. So within the week, I like to touch it up a little bit, get a nice little lineup as well. And then I'm gonna allow my top to grow back, because I feel like, you know, I've been doing a low cut for the past like year or so it's time to bring it back. And then I'm gonna shave down my mustache, because I tried it out for this shoot to kind of give that Fresh Prince of Bel-Air look. Time to let that go. So let's make breakfast. Feeling pretty lean. I think I've dropped about like 8 pounds since starting my cut. Let's see that. Obliques, all that kind of look pretty good. Can't complain. All right, running a little bit late, but we got like a hockey jersey on with these super over baggy cargo super denim jeans with my neutral grays on. So, gotta go get a haircut real quick. Let me zoom out. Gotta get a haircut real quick. So I have all my stuff packed up. So I have my water change for my workouts. So I got the new purple retro 90s retro shorts, shoes, don't mind this, it's literally just some packages, new clothes. So then I have my pre-workout shake along with my two rice cakes, creatine, and my salt for my pre-workout shake. I have like two pre-workout shakes. I have like what coincides with my pre-workout meal, which is going to be my protein or my whey protein shake, and then I have like my actual pre-workout like creatine shake that's like also filled with salt as well. So, all right, I'm gonna also do my check-ins as I get my haircut, because I have to tell my coach basically like the routine that I've been doing, like what I've been eating and all that kind of stuff, my feedback, comments, concerns, any mishaps that I may have had during the couple of days, and that's gonna be pretty much it. So let's go ahead and get this chop. Also got a meeting with Wheez and Dion about the singlets that you guys have been waiting to drop. So it's the singlet that I competed in. It's the Black Mamba singlet. Still in some R&D. It's like one little thing that we gotta change, but we're almost there. So what's up, guys? We're here at the shoot. We're at the roller rink getting our shots. So we already hit some shots kind of like over there. And then we're kind of working our way around. So we also got shots over here. And then we're gonna move over to that gaming section. And then judging on how like the shots look, we might actually go on the roller rink itself. But we just like the vibe of what we're getting here, because it gives very like
fun type of like
old school 90s vibes, but this is by far like the best like modeling group that we've had. They look really good in the clothes. So we're just gonna kind of get that good vibe. We have everything kind of like lined up for them to kind of just get into and shoot. So yeah, check this out. Behind the scenes, all that kind of stuff. We got a hair over there. All right.
3, 2. Perfect.
Right?
It's okay.
Actually, also thank you, Josh, for making this playlist. Josh is the creator of this 90s hip hop and R&B playlist because he's nice with the playlist. I came in front.
A little bit more,
All right, we just wrapped up the shoot. Took 2 hours actually, so we were able to get amazing content. So all the footage that we got, camera, all that kind of stuff is like amazing. So let me run you through the video that I have here. Look at this. Damn it. There you go. Yeah, but this is probably easily our best organized shoot. We got all the content we needed, website photos. We're gonna have like the video to make like a teaser trailer, the trailer. The pictures look absolutely great. The clothes that we got, or the shoot that we decided to shoot for the venue, matches the clothes that we're dropping. Like everything was on point. We were very efficient. So I'm super excited to show you guys kind of like everything that's gonna be rolling out in the next couple of days. By the time this video goes up, we would probably already be in the midst of dropping everything, but I'm super excited to show you guys, man. I'm very, very excited for this drop. So now we're going straight to the gym. I'm gonna eat my pre-workout meal on the way to the gym, and we're gonna work out. So very successful. How do you feel the shoot went, Duhan?
That was probably the best shoot we've ever done.
Yeah.
As far as like efficiency,
yeah.
Content,
yeah.
Vibes. Bro, if you're not on with GBT now, you're missing out, baby.
Yes, sir.
Doing that shit.
Yes, sir. Come a long way from shooting in the gym randomly with some people. Everything is like now kind of a lot more streamlined and like done with the purpose. So time to work out. All right, guys, I'm gonna speed through this workout. So I'm already 2 sets deep. We just have a 3x6 on bench with 315 pounds, nothing too crazy. And then after that, we're gonna be doing probably like, maybe like a chest and tri workout real quick. And then we have to knock down this 15 minutes of cardio. I low key just wanna get back to the crib, eat some good food, watch some good stuff and relax. It's been a long ass week. And I just wanna cap it off very nicely, so. Third set, 6 reps. Game time. I swear they just be lying when they come to the side of the game stop. Out of the change, they just swerve right into my kids' lane. Same truth that you stop racing and shift change to show me the city that I was out here playing. What I said seems to never extinguish. Coolest kid out, baby, word of Chuck English. Got my own money, see the paper cup finish. My song is your girlfriend's waking up, bring up. So we're done with the workout. I kind of had to cut it short just because, you know, I just want to get out of here pretty quickly. I don't want to get into the late evening time. If I had finished my whole workout, I would have been back like around like 7:30-ish. And I just wanted to go ahead and start my cardio. So we're already working on that. I'm 25 minutes down basically. So right in the midway point of it. So I'm gonna knock this down, head back to the crib and relax. So I just wanted to kind of give you guys an update with this vlog about what's been going on. Like I said, I'm taking a break from powerlifting to do bodybuilding. I'm gonna be tackling that head on. I'm about 3 to 4 weeks into my prep. So I'll be announcing more detail things as we get deeper and deeper into it. I just don't want to start a prep series like 12 weeks out because it gets kind of redundant. And I want to give you guys fresh content. So whenever I do lock in, give you guys like constant updates, and won't be as, you know, long of a series. So I hope you guys are able to kind of catch up as to what's been going on lately. We got the biggest drop in GBT history coming up September, coming up in the next week or so. Yeah, a lot of exciting things. Still hitting heavyweights, just cutting now. So thank you guys for tuning into today's video. Like always, if you guys like today's video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. It's been nice catching up with you guys. Get better today. I'm out.